students, today we shall be discussing about the alpha decay. So in the alpha decay, first we discuss about the alpha particle spectrum. As you know that when the parent atom disintegrates to daughter nucleus, it could emit alpha particle. So the alpha particle that are emitted from the parent nucleus are not only found to have only one particular energy. So it has found that there are number of alpha particles emitted with varying energy. So the spectra of the alpha particle was grouped into three categories, where the first type of spectra consisted of a single group or a line spectra. Here, only one type of alpha particle was emitted having one particular energy. So, such type of spectra was called the single group or line. So, the examples of these were radon, radium A, and radon F. So, in this, it was found that the single group or the line had one particular type of energy. So all the alpha particles that were released from this radium or radon were having only one particular energy. So the second type of group of the alpha particle spectra was that the spectra consisted of two or more discrete, means they had two energy levels, closely spaced components with same or slightly different magnitude of the intensity, means very closely spaced or very small difference was there in the energy levels of the alpha particles that were emitted. So the examples of this type of spectra was thorium C, actinium X, thorium X, palladium, radium actinium series. So these parent nuclei emitted the alpha particle, which consisted of two types of energies of the alpha particle, and the difference in the energies of the two types of alpha particles that were emitted were very, very small. So the next type of, the third type of the alpha particle spectra that was found, that the spectra consisted of a main group. So it had a main group and a group which had higher energy particles. So in its, the particle had a particular alpha particle where it was having some value of 8 mega electron volt. But a higher order alpha particle was also emitted, that is the 10 mega electron volt was also emitted in this case. But the number that was found for the higher was very, very small in comparison to the main group. So the examples of this type of spectra which showed were the short-lived nuclei of radium C dash and thorium C dash. So this type of spectra consisted for the examples of radium C dash and thorium C dash, where they consisted of a main group consisting of energy of alpha particle, and an alpha particle was also created having a slightly higher energy than the main group, but the number that was there of these alpha particles was quite small, very, very less, very fractional amount of the higher energy alpha particles that were released were just fractional amount of numbers. So, if we consider the alpha particle spectra, that the parent nuclei is disintegrating into the daughter nucleus and an alpha particle is disintegrating, and we assume that the parent nucleus is at rest. So, we calculate the kinetic energies involved in the reaction. So, as you know that the parent nuclei is at rest, so the kinetic energy of the parent nuclei will be zero. Since the daughter nucleus is recoiling and the alpha particle is also moving, so the kinetic energies will be related to the daughter nucleus as well as the alpha particle. So the total kinetic energy of the reaction will be the sum of the kinetic energies of the product side. So it is the kinetic energy of the Y daughter nucleus and the kinetic energy of the alpha particle. So this total energy, this total kinetic energy is also called the total disintegration energy of the reaction. It is called the total alpha disintegration energy, represented by E alpha. So if we represent that, let Vy and V be the velocity of the daughter nucleus and the alpha particle, and let my and m is the mass of the daughter nucleus and the alpha particle. So the alpha disintegration energy will be what? That is the sum of kinetic energies. So we can write that E alpha is equal to half of mv square plus half of my vy square. So according to the law of conservation of momentum, we can conserve the momentum also. So what is there? Since m and v are the masses and velocities of y, and m alpha v alpha is the mass and velocity of the alpha particle, so mv is equal to my vy. So from this we can calculate the value of vy, that is the velocity of the daughter nucleus. So substitute the value of vy, which is mv upon my. So e alpha is half mv square plus half my m square upon my square v square. So here my and my gets cancelled. So what we get, mv square comes out. So get half mv square 1 plus m upon my. And this half mv square is nothing but the energy of the alpha particle, kinetic energy of the alpha particle, which we represented as E. So we can write that this E alpha is equal to E 1 plus m upon my. So where E is what? E is the energy of the alpha particle. So from the spectral series, we can calculate these alpha disintegration energy. So now let us look at the spectral decay of the alpha decay of the thorium C to thorium C dash, where thorium C is your bismuth 212, that is the parent nuclei, and thorium C double dash is the thallium 200A. So the bismuth 212 is decaying to thallium 200A, not only one alpha decay, that is only not only one type of alpha with particular energy is disintegrated, but we see that closely spaced decay schemes are there, where a lot of energies of the alpha particles are seen. So what we see that there are intermediate levels between the highest excited state and the lowest ground state of the thallium 208 and the bismuth 212. So we see that the bismuth 212 not only disintegrates or decays to thallium 208 by just emitting the one alpha particle of having 6.203 MeV of disintegration energy, but it decays in series of alpha decays, where not only it decays towards some metastable states or intermediate states, and it gives off the gamma rays as well. So here we can see that the thorium C gives a disintegration energy of 5.584 and lands up to the higher excited state of 0.619 mega electron volt, and in the series of gamma decays, here you can see it can give off a gamma ray here, and from 0.473 mega electron volt again decays to gives off gamma ray and then returns to the ground state of thallium 208, or it could decay from thorium C, then it could decay from 0.329, it could decay to 0.040, and then from 0.040 again it can give a series of gamma ray and then come to the ground state of thallium 208. So there are many ways in which the bismuth 212 can come to thallium 208. So here we have seen that there are six types of alpha disintegration energies involved, and a large number of gamma rays are emitted out. That with gamma ray will be the emitted will be the equal to the difference of the energy levels that is being produced. So if we want to calculate the alpha disintegration energy, so we have already calculated this formula, that alpha disintegration energy E alpha was E into 1 plus m upon my, where m is the mass of alpha particle and my is the mass of the daughter nucleus. So if we want to calculate this E alpha, so E is the mass energy of the alpha particle, 4 is the mass of the alpha particle, and 208 is the mass of the daughter nucleus. So 208 here, 48. So we calculate the result. So we get that E alpha is 53/52 times of E. So if we substitute the value of the E that is carried by the alpha particle, so what we see, that if we see that if the alpha particle carries an energy of 6.086 mega electron volt, substituting the value of 6.086 mega electron volt in this equation, what we see that the alpha disintegration energy is coming out to be 53/52 into 6.086 mega electron volt is 6.203 mega electron volt. So this is the E alpha that is disintegrated. So here alpha naught will have energy of carry the kinetic energy of 6.086 mega electron volt. Then the thorium C bismuth will directly decay to the ground state of the thallium 208. So these are the various excited levels of thorium 208 where the bismuth was decaying by various modes of alpha decay and then for successive disintegrations by the gamma decays. So here what we see that if an alpha particle is emitted of the kinetic energy of 6.047, then the alpha disintegration energy involved in the reaction comes out to be 6.163. So the thorium C, that is bismuth 212, lands up to the excited state of 0.040 of the thallium 208, and then with the successive disintegration by the gamma ray, it lands up to the ground state of thallium 208. So this is the experimental or the theoretical verification of the decay scheme of the alpha decay, where we are also getting these disintegration energies, and practically and by the formula also we are seeing the same result. So we can say that we had six types of alphas that could be possible, that the thorium C bismuth 212 could land to the different excited states of the thallium 208, and then by successive disintegrating by the emission of the gamma rays, it could come to the ground state. So I hope that the alpha particle spectra and the decay spectra of the alpha decay is clear to you. So thank you, students.